Hello and welcome back to Cracking the Cryptic, and something very interesting to happen today. I don't know what we're going to get here. I really have no idea. I'll tell you about that in a moment. I do first of all want to mention our extra content on our apps, of course, always very popular. People have been continuing to buy them throughout January. I think maybe they help people get through lockdown in a better frame of mind. The details are all in the description field under the video. Also, all the extra content on Patreon, including Simon's harder classic solve yesterday. It's a really intricate puzzle. I mean, brilliant work by Sam Kappelman Lines, as so often. And brilliant work by Simon solving it, frankly. I don't solve classic Sudoku that way. Definitely worth a watch. Now, I was hoping to have a go at the German Championship this weekend, but I have got tons to do. We are working on a new update for the Miracle app. We are working on the book puzzles. Good grief, yes. We have lots to do in various fields. But so have some of you, and you've been having a go at the Patreon content, and what I was going to say was I don't know if I'm going to have time to do that German Championship. It's a two-hour test I read today, so that's quite a while. I don't know. Hopefully I will over the weekend. And it is available at Logic Masters Germany once you register, which I finally did. Can you believe I wasn't registered there before now? I thought I was, but I wasn't. Anyway, we are going to congratulate people who finished Reverence Puzzle Hunt. That's one of the things on Patreon. Mike Ewing, Dennis Josephson, Billy Suter, Simon Sontag, and Nico and Joyce together since we last updated you on those. We're still going to give you some time before we publish a solution to that, which will probably be a document rather than a video, I imagine. So that will be coming. Now, right. Now, this puzzle, okay, it looks interesting to start with. Lots of, I was going to say white, black and grey dots, but I'm not going to say that. Now, the story here is that Under Beyond wrote to Simon and said, Dance1211 has contacted me with an idea that I find brilliant. We then collaborated to implement the idea and created our first collab Sudoku. However, since the idea was a bit out of the box, it seems to be quite controversial among the testers that tested the Sudoku, which we thought might be interesting to the community. This time we'd like to have Mark try the puzzle out since it requires a bit less logic and a bit more on something else. Now, I don't know what that means. I'll read the rules in a minute and then maybe, well, I'll read the rules now and tell you what I think they might mean, but I might be wrong. Normal Sudoku rules apply. Consecutive digits are separated by a white dit. Digits with a 1-to-2 ratio are separated by a black dot. Each grey dot either acts as a white dit or a black dot. Decrypting the grey dots will reveal the final step. The negative constraint applies. And we'd like to thank Alice Quodeck, Ahout, Clover, Joseph, Sam, Christopher, Reverend, Afraid Not, Rye Smith, and two more for testing. My God, that's a phalanx of testers there. Really is a battery of bright sparks. Now, I'm getting pretty scared. What on earth does this mean? Mark should try it since it requires a bit less logic and a bit more something else. Well, I'm known for being prepared to bifurcate, although I try not to do it on the channel too much. So it could be that, I guess. I guess I've also been involved in final steps in puzzle hunts and listeners, but so's Simon. I did look at the decrypting bit and I wondered whether that's something that they expect me to be able to do. And I have got ready a table of Morse and Braille letters, because they're codes involving dots. I don't know. No idea if that's going to be necessary, but I'm prepared just in case. Now, Simon added to this, he expects me to do the video in half an hour, and I take it that's a joke. I don't know if he's even done the puzzle, or if he's winding me up. I don't know. Maybe, I don't know what it's about, frankly. Maybe he has looked at a solution document and he has some idea what's going on. I can tell you I don't. I haven't studied the puzzle at all. Gonna give it a go now. You try it if you want on the link below the video, and let's see what happens. I've read you the rules. I've put them up as well. So let's see what happens and let's get cracking. So, I mean, there's tons of dots here, but only blacks and whites have their known function. Although it's quite interesting that the negative constraint applies. Okay, we've got two blacks in one box there. We've got two here as well. Now, I know that this connection must be a white dot because you can't have three black dots connected within one box. Yes, you can. 1, 2, 4, 8. Okay, I'm talking absolute balderdash there. Right, where do we start here? Strings of grey dots, they're not very useful, frankly, so I'm not expecting to make much of those. So I need to use where we get white and black dots. And we don't get many. This grid looks like it's full of dots of all different colours, but there's not very many. I guess every cell in this box is connected by a dot to something. So wherever the 5, 7, and 9 are, they're on an effective white dot. That's an interesting thought, maybe, because these cells can't involve 5, 7, or 9 since they're on black dots. So 5, 7, and 9 must be in this group of cells on white dots. One must be in each group. In fact, this must be 5, 7, or 9 connected to a number on a black one, a ratio dot. Then this is another of them, and this is another of them. But I don't know where the 5, 7, or 9 would be on those ones. I think that must be right. This is then consecutive with 5, 7, or 9. So it's 8, 6, or 4. Here we can have 4, 3, I suppose 2 or 8 now. Now, if 5, 7, and 9 are all connected here, they're connected by white dots. They're not using 2 and 1, or 3 actually. 1, 2, and 3 must all be in this segment. So 3 and 6 must be one of these pairs, and 1 and 2 must be the other. I think that's right. And this one can't be 1 and 2. So this is the 3, 6 one. I hope that logic's right. I don't see why it's not. That connects to 5 or 7. We get 1 and 2 here. Now, whichever this one is connected to 3. So that is 2 being connected to 3. Then 6 is connected to 5 or 7, but we know that 9 is connected to 8 somewhere, and 7 is therefore connected to 6 in this box, so that's the one here. These also include 5 and 4. This one can't be 9 because it's in the middle of a string of whites, so that one can't be 8, but therefore this either goes 4, 5, or 5, 4, thus ending in a 3, 6, or 7, but not ending. That carries on to either 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, or 8 here. A couple of those are ruled out by that. In fact, 4, 3, 4, 5, that's quite constrained, but it is possible. Now, what's up here? Trouble is we don't know the color of this dot. This can't be a 3-6 pair because of that. But that's not really very helpful. I mean, that's a decent start. This can't be a 3-6 pair either. These are all connected, but that dot could be any color. Oh, okay. This is connected to 4, 5, or 9. So if it was by a white dot, a dit, we get 4 or 8 there. But if it's by a black one to the 4, we can have 2 or 8. Okay, that's a fairly limited population. But that is then connected by a white dot to an odd digit of some sort, but it could be any of them. But that means this is even. Am I going to have to start parity colouring the grid? Doesn't feel like there's enough white dots to do that with, but you never know. Oh, and this is a black dot in a I'm a bit in two minds about parity colouring. It just doesn't feel necessary yet, because I'm only getting a few dots that I know are connected by whites to one cell. That is quite interesting. Now, I was going to look at this black dot. This can't be 1, 2, or 2, 4. So it's either 4, 8, or 3, 6. Now, if it was 3, 6, this would be 7. Ah, I think the possibility of this being 3 has disappeared now. Because if that's 3, this is 4, and then both of these possibilities are gone. Right, so that's not 3. And therefore, this isn't 4. Oh, that's only one of the possibilities. Bother. So this either comes up 4, 5, 6, or comes down 9, 8, 7. So this can't be 4 anymore, but it can still be 5 with the 6, or 6 or 8 with the 7. And there's a negative constraint. I haven't used that at all yet. Ah, and maybe that's the point. Yes, that's quite interesting. That now means, say that was 4. Oh no, this can't be 5. That's one thing it means. And this can't be 8. That's another thing it means. Oh, the negative constraint's much more powerful than I was allowing for. Come on, use that. 6 or 7. I mean, I think I am using logic. I don't know what else to be doing, frankly. If there's something cleverer to do, I'm not doing it, but there we go. I'll live with that. If that's 3, 6, we've got a pair there and a pair there. We would have to put... Okay, if that's 3, 6, then we have 7 here and 8 here. But if it's 4, 8, then we don't have 8 here. But then 5 and 6 are still both possible. One has to be down here. I don't think one can connect by a dot to any of those candidates, so one must be in this cell. That's quite surprising. I don't know where to be looking. This is frustrating. I feel like I'm absolutely on the verge of a breakthrough. 3, 6 looks like it's hard here. Then we have 7, 8, 8, 9, 5, 4. Maybe I'm just missing a connection. Oh, this was nonsense up here, because there's no reason this couldn't have been 3 or 5 connecting to the 4. Okay, let's get rid of those odd and even. I don't think the parity shading had any grounds in common sense. Okay, this is connected to 5 or 8. So it's got to be 4, 6, 7, or 9. This can't be 3, 6, or 1 now, but it's on a black dot, so it's 2, 4, or 8. However, if it was 4, okay, yeah, and then this would be 8. If it's 2, this could be 1 or 4, and if it's 8, that's a 4. So that's a fairly limited range again. It's not quite getting anything done. There's a white dot here. And that can't involve 1, 2, 3, or 6. So it's either 4, 5, or it does involve an 8. And that means this is not a 4-8 pair. That's right. In fact, it's either 4, 5, or it involves an 8. And that means with that cell, they use up 4 and 8 in a kind of hypothetical pair in the row. So that can't be 4 or 8 and must be 2. Now, that doesn't tell me whether this is 1 or 4, but surely I'm getting closer now. 1, 2, 3, 6. So this is either 4, 5, or 7, 8, or 8, 9. 4 and 8 are used up. So these are from 5, 7, and 9. Now, that means this is... Okay, I can use a bit of parity. This is even, obviously. No, not obvious. Yes, it is obvious, because they can't be on a black dot. So it is even. This must be odd. That must be 7. Oh, I still don't know whether that's 6 or 8, but I do know this is 8, this is 9, this is 5, this is 4. Now, this isn't 4, 5, so it involves 8 and either 7 or 9. This can't be 5 because it's next to 4. And it can't be 7 because we put 7 in the box. It's 9, it must be next to 8. That works with the white dot, that's good. This is not 8, 4, that's 3, 6. The 3 couldn't connect to any of those things, so that's a 6. This is 5. We've got 2 and 4 up here. Now, both of those connect to each other and connect by a white dot to the 3, and neither connects to the 6, so I can't disambiguate them. But we get 3, 5, and 6 here. Now, how do we connect those up? Surely with a 6 in the middle, because it can black dot to the 3 and white dot to the 5. I think that's right. Now they connect together with a white dot, so that's a 4 now. 3, 5, 6, 4, 2, 8's been... Oh, we've got 1 and 9 here, so this is now a 7, 8 pair. Yes. I don't know which way round they go, or which way round these go. Or these. Okay, but we've got lots of numbers in the middle. Now this can't be 6 anymore. This one has to connect to 9, so I think that has to be 8. That's got to be right. This can't be 8, 4, 6, 3. So it involves a 2 and either a 1 or a 4. This now can't be a black dot, so it's a white one involving something from 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. Ah, but a 2 is involved up here. So this white dit must involve the other even number. So the 4 is down here and not up here. So this is 4, 3, and 5. That can't be the 4, or it would join up with both the 3 and the 5. So that's the 4. 3 and 5 are below it. 8, 1, 2. This is now not... it could still be 4. That's not a black dot, so it can't be 4. 7 or 9, so this is even. 8 or 6, it's clearly 6. White dot to there is a 5. This is not 4. Oh, this is now 7, that's resolved. 8, 7, 6, this is a black dot without an 8 or a 6, so it's definitely got a 2 and either a 1 or a 4. That one can't be the 1. So we've got a 2-4 pair here. 2-4-3-1. 5-6-7-8-9 to put in. So this is a white dot down here. This is the kind of odd one out, so it's odd. Literally the odd one out. Because there's got to be an even number on both of those dots. Now, I'm probably missing negative constraints because they're quite hard to pick up, frankly. 8 and 4 there, 3 there. This is a 1-2 pair. 1, 2, 7, 8, 5, 4. We've got 3, 6, and 9. 3 has to be up here, and it can't be with the 6, or there'd be a dot between them. So it's with the 9. There's a white dot there, so that's 2, 3, 1, 9. 5, 4, and 6 over here. Again, they're not all connected. So I think the five, the middle digit, has to be at the end. And then these two can be four and six. Aha! And there's no dot here, so it couldn't be a four at the top. 7, 8, 9 here, they are all connected. So the eight is in the middle this time. 7 and 9 on the ends. This is going fine now. Right, this can't be a 4 or a 3 because of that 6. So it's a 1 or a 2, making this on the black dot 1, 2 or 4. But not connected to this at all. So this can't be 2 or 1. That must be 4 with 1 there. 2, black dot makes that a 2. We've got 3 and 1, so 3 there, 1 there, that's all right. Now that is a 2-4 pair. 1, 9 and 3 to go in here. On the black dot we can't have 9, and we also can't have 1 because 2 there would clash with 2 here. So we can put in 3 and 6, that's solved the 5-3 pair. 7 must be there. 8 and 9 must be connected there, yes. Then we've got the 8 at the start of the row to tell us which way round. By Sudoku, that's a 1. Oh yeah, the white dot is allowed. Doesn't have to be black. For some reason I haven't put 9 in those as a possibility. 6, 2, 4. These are 3 and 7. Well, obviously on the white dot, that's 3, 7, then 8 and 9 at the top. Ooh, I was going to go, oh no, that can't be 9, 8, 7, 6, but 8 can jump to a 4 with a black dot. 2 and 8 here. Ah. Don't think anything tells me which way round they go. 3's not possible there anymore. No, surely some negative constraint's going to sort out that 2 by 2. Or maybe the final step, you never know. Right, that can't be 7. 2, 1, 4, 3, 9, 6. This is 8, 7 as a pair. Ah, 8 can't be next to the 4, and also actually there's an 8 in the row. That's an 8, 2, 4, 3, 5, 6 and 9, and these are joined. So they must be 5 and 6, yes. 9 here, that fixes the 7, 9 pair. The 5, 3 pair has been resolved. That does fix the 5, 6 pair there. Then we get 6 and 2. 3, 4, 7 and 5 to go. 3 and 5 up here. Well, 2 can't be joined to 5 in any way. 4 and 7 down here, yes. 8, 7. 2 and 8 up here. Now, I've got 2 deadly patterns left. But 8 should be joined by a dot if it was 9 here. So that's resolved. I just don't think this set is resolved. So I could be missing something. Could easily be missing something. But I cannot see how that's resolved. So I think maybe we're going to have to resolve it using the final step. Now, I'm favouring Morse because of that word dit in the instructions. Dit is used for the dot in Morse and da is used for the dash. So if the whites are dits and the blacks are da's, what do we have at the top? We have, yeah, look, we have a string of 3. Oddly, we have a string of 5 characters there. Then 4 there, 5 there, 2, 3, 5. Now, 5's too long. Oh, there are numbers in Morse. I don't know if I've called that up. Anyway, I think this goes white, black, white, which is dit, da, dit. Let's have a look at my Morse. Dit, da, dit is R, isn't it? Yes. I do remember some of these, but not all of them. So maybe that first row is R. But then here we've got dit, dit, dit. That must be black and that must be black. So da, da. Now did I have the numbers? I do have the numbers here. 3. Dit, 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 da, da. Okay. Well, it's either 3 or it could be 2 dots separated by a bar and then dot dash dash, which would be I dot dash dash W. That's not very promising. So I reckon R3 is probably where we are at the moment. Now this next one, four symbols, and we're going dash dot dash dot. That sounds like a character. Later one. Oh yes, C, not a later one, an earlier one. R3C. I mean, this is going to be a very cryptic message if it really does work like that. Dot, 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 dot. They're all consecutives. Five dots. Five. Ah, R3C5, row 3, column 5. Row 3, column 5. So this is going to disambiguate row 3, column 5. That's gorgeous. So here we have dot dot for an I. Is that an I? Oh, sorry, I've gone for the wrong thing there. Dot dot for, yes, I. S would be dot dot dot. Yes, yes, yes. So row 3, column 5 is, and here comes the final number, dot, 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 dash. Oh, I keep going to the wrong thing. Dot, 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 dash, 4. So row 3, column 5 is 4, and that does disambiguate the final step of the Sudoku. I like that. I mean, I don't know. I can see why it's controversial among testers. That is an intriguing finish to a puzzle of this sort. So I have come in under the half hour. So there, Simon. And that was an intriguing puzzle with an intriguing finish. Thank God DIT was in the instructions to make it clear it was Morse. Frankly, I'd have tried Morse with a dot code anyway. As I say, Braille seems to be the other popular alternative. Great fun, that. I hope that was interesting for you. Maybe you jumped to the finish if you've seen this puzzle somewhere before in Logic Masters Germany. I'll post a link to that as well. But thank you very much for watching, and hope to see you again on the channel soon. Do subscribe if you haven't already, and lots more content coming, of course. Bye for now.